So, what's up, YouTube? Bronix with it and a tutorial. And in this tutorial, I'll show you guys the easiest way to create your presets or LUTs for color grading, and also how to create your skin retouching actions that are going to fasten your color grading and also skin retouching process in Photoshop. So let me show you guys how to create those actions and how to save them into your computer. So the very first thing we're going to be dealing with is how to create your skin retouching or your frequency separation actions in Photoshop. These are going to be like more of shortcuts that are going to enable you speed up or fasten your skin retouching process. So in order to create your actions, the very first thing you have to know is, first of all, coming right here to window. So when you come to window and come to actions, it is going to open for you or create for you this action window right here. So this is my set for my action. So I'm just going to close that for purposes of being uniform. So in order to create your actions in a given folder or a given group, you basically have to, first of all, create that folder. So first of all, the very first thing, just come right here and create a new set. So a folder is more of a set. So you can name this set to maybe a retouching for purposes of being a uniform. So I'm just going to name that to a retouching rather. So after doing that, just come and hit OK. So you can see it has created just a new set or folder for us right here. So we want to create the very first action for a skin retouching or frequency separation. So in order to create that action, you have to simply come right down here and come and click on this plus icon. So under this, you can see we have name, set, function key, and the color. So for this case, we're going to first of all create an 8-bit frequency separation action. So I'm just going to do that because most people prefer to do 8-bit skin or frequency separation. So let's just do that. So that is the name for our action. And the set is this folder where this action is going to be saved. So you can even assign a function key for your action, but for this case, it doesn't really matter. So you can even come down here and assign a color. So you're just going to choose red and simply come and hit record. So when you hit record, you're going to notice that this record button is going to be automatically updated and it's going to be red in color for this case. So in order to start recording your action, you have to simply come to the background and create two layers. Remember, frequency separation divides the image into two. That is the high frequency that contains the textures and the low frequency which contains the colors or skin tones of an image. So you're going to create those two layers by selecting the background layer and hitting Ctrl Command J twice, just like that. And after doing all that, we're just going to come and rename this to maybe low frequency, and we can simply name this to high frequency, so whichever name you prefer to use. So after we have done all that, we're just going to simply come down here, first of all deactivate the high frequency layer and come and select the low frequency layer. So the reason for doing all this is because we want to blur out or remove textures from the low frequency layer to remain with the colors or the skin tones in this particular image. So you're going to come to filter and come to blur and come to Gaussian blur. So when you're creating your frequency separation layers or actions, you basically shouldn't mind about this. But what you should know about this step is make sure you zoom into the image up to a point when you're looking at the textures in the image really. So you have to look for that sweet spot that has more textures than the rest of the skin in the image and simply move this radius up to when these details are getting to disappear from the image. So, and when you're comfortable or when you're done doing all that, simply come and hit OK. So we want to set our action in a way that it is going to stop on this very step so that we can put in various radiuses for the varying type of images we'll be retouching. So in order to do that, just come and select this tiny box right here. So check it. So this is going to stop the action at this very point when it is playing, so that we can adjust the radius for our different images that we're going to be retouching. And after doing that, come and select the high frequency layer. So we only want to remain with the textures in the high frequency layer. So select it and now bring back the visibility of the high frequency layer and come to image and come down to apply image, just like this. So when you come to apply image, I'm just going to move this towards this side. We have to ensure that we select this layer because we want to subtract the skin textures from this low frequency layer. So the layer that we are going to be subtracting the textures from has to be selected. So come and select that low frequency layer. So for 8-bit images, I'm just going to close this briefly. For 8-bit images, you have to make sure that you change the blending mode from multiply and change it to subtract. Make sure the opacity is 100. Preserve transparency and mask are not checked. Invert is also not checked and your preview is on. Then the scale has to be 2 and offset 128, and you can click OK. And for 16-bit images, because I don't want to go all over these actions again, so for 16-bit images, as you can see, this is 8. 16-bit images, the blending mode is always add. Opacity at 100, preserve transparency and mask are not checked. The scale is always 2 and offset 0. But the difference here is make sure that you turn on the invert option. And when you do that, you're going to notice that your textures are on this gray kind of layer. So since we are dealing with an 8-bit image, turn off the invert, blending mode, change it to subtract, opacity at 100, scale is 2, then offset 128, and make sure your preview is on, and hit OK. So when you hit OK, come and change the blending mode from whichever it is, and look for a linear light, and you'll get back the image the way it is meant to look. So after you have done all that, we have to now create a black and white layer. The reason for this is because when we are using a mixer brush tool, we are going to be using the black and white layer to show us the uneven skin tones when you are trying to blend or even them very well. So just come to the adjustments and come and select black and white. And it is going to change the image into black and white. So click like right here and just darken the reds just like that. So after doing all that, you're going to select all these layers just like that by holding down Ctrl and selecting all of the layers, including the black and white, and simply hit Ctrl or Command G on the keyboard to group them. So we can easily name that to a frequency, just like that, separation. So you are just going to open this. So and you're going to come down and now simply select the low frequency layer. Remember, we just need a step ahead for our retouching. And when you're done doing that, simply come down here to, or up here to the actions, and simply hit the stop option. So just stop it. And you notice that this has been deactivated. So you're just going to close all this. So you can see this is our action right here. So let's see if at all you have done or created this action really well. So I'm just going to close this and delete this group for frequency separation. Come under the actions and select the 8-bit and come to the play option and play this action. You can see it has stopped at this point, whereby we have to select the radius for our Gaussian blur and simply hit OK. It is going to continue playing and continue creating all those folders for us automatically. And you can see it has automatically selected the low frequency layer, so that you can just get the mixer brush tool or whichever tool you prefer to use for skin retouching. So basically, this is how to create your frequency separation actions in Photoshop. So the next thing we are going to tackle is how to create your Photoshop LUTs. So LUTs are more of filters or color grading filters or presets that are going to enable us maybe color grade the image or apply different colors to the images with just a single click in Photoshop. So in order to create these LUTs, we simply have to come and do some tiny bit of adjustments to the image. So this is an already retouched image and it has already been color graded. So in order to create your LUTs for your images, always make sure that you don't have any folders, or maybe if at all you have been doing retouching or adjustments to the image, make sure you don't have any folders in it. So make sure you flatten or merge all those layers before you can start creating your LUTs for color grading. So let's just come down here and just do some little bit of adjustments so that you can save them as a preset. So I'm basically going to come down here and I'm just going to come to the black and white. And after doing that, I'm just going to change the blending mode maybe to a multiply. And now come the opacity and simply reduce on the opacity. So we just want to do some little bit of adjustments right on this image. So I'm just going to come to a selective color. So whichever settings we're going to be applying are going to be saved for us. So I'm just going to come to the reds and just intensify the reds in the image just like that. And I can come down to the blacks and also simply do that for my blacks. Just want a little bit and just turn this down like that. And I think that is it. So let's just come to the color balance. So all these adjustments are going to be embedded into our color grading preset or our Photoshop LUT for this very image. So I'm just going to come to the color balance option and I'm going to basically come to the midtones rather and add some little bit of blues to the midtones. I think that is fine. So this is for purposes of showing you how to create your LUTs for color grading. So when you feel like you have done everything, don't put all these in a group, just leave them as plain layers. And when you feel like you're comfortable with these adjustments, so when you're creating your LUTs, you have to do everything to the extreme, because when you apply the LUT, you have the option of turning down the opacity. So make sure you do everything to the extreme. And after you have done all your adjustments, simply come right here to File, just like this, and come to Export, and you come all the way to Lookup Tables. So when you come to Lookup Tables, we have the description for the LUT. So you can name your LUT whatever you want. So you can just name this maybe test LUT, just like that. And you can as well add copyright to your LUT. Then you can now come down here and leave these the way they are. So make sure you select cube, because this is going to be faster in Photoshop. So after doing all that, come and simply hit OK. And you can save your LUT the way you want. Maybe test LUT. I think that is fine. And folder, I want to save it on my desktop, and simply hit save, just like that. So it is going to be saved automatically and it is going to open the image back into Photoshop. So this is the image we have right now. So we want to see if at all we have successfully created our LUT for the color grading process. I'm just going to put this in a group by hitting Ctrl Command G on the keyboard and deactivating this right here. So it has hidden all the adjustments we initially did. So in order to apply the LUT, come to the background, and now you're just going to come down here and come to Color Lookup. So when you come to Color Lookup, just come all the way down to Load 3D LUT. So just come, I'm just going to click on that. And you can see it has brought this option right here. So my LUT is on the desktop, and I'm just going to go all the way down and look for my LUT. I know my desktop is really messed up, so I'm just going to look for test. So this is the LUT we had. So just come and hit open, and you can see it has created the very same effect that we had in this folder. So when you feel like your LUT is really too much on the image, you can simply come and reduce on the opacity. That's why I told you guys, when you're creating your LUT, just make sure that you do it to extreme so that you can adjust it when you apply it on different kinds of images to really have that kind of flexible option for yourself. So you can see this is the before and the after, before, after. So basically this is how to create your LUTs or Photoshop presets for color grading. And so this tutorial has basically been about how to create your skin retouching actions basically frequency separation actions, and also how to create your Photoshop LUTs for color grading skin tones and various images in Photoshop. And if at all you have loved this very tutorial, don't forget to like this video, don't forget to subscribe this channel. If at all you have been watching from this channel for the very first time, Ronix from Ronix Photography, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in yet another tutorial. And don't forget to keep practicing, keep creating, and save and create these LUTs, because they are going to fasten and improve your photography and skin retouching process in general. And I'll see you in yet another one.